Good morning to all. I am Dr. K. Kaleeswaran, Professor of Mechanical Engineering at Dr. N.G. Institute of Technology. Today, I want to share some information about introduction to metrology. Metrology is a very important part in industry scenario. In industry, in the manufacturing point of view, the measurement plays a vital role because once the product has been manufactured, it has to be inspected with the help of measuring instruments. So, in order to inspect the component and in order to retain the quality of the product, the measuring instruments and the person who is having the scale, who is going to handle the measuring instrument, should have the adequate knowledge in engineering metrology. Engineering metrology, the basic terms of metrology mean it is a measure of science. It is here the measure of science means actually it starts from the Greek way. It is a metrology, it is a measure of physical quantity. In generally, the metrology has been categorized into two categories. One is called it is a legal metrology. The second one is called is a deterministic metrology. Then apart from that, there is a medical metrology also available. If we look at the legal metrology, in the legal metrology, we'll deal with about the what kind of method of measurement, what kind of instrument can be used, what is the units for measurement, all the category has been described by the National Laboratory, that is NSLM. NSLM is nothing but National Standard Legal Metrology. Every state or nation will have the NSLM laboratory in the own country. So that's why it is called it is a national legal NSLM. National Service Legal Metrology. In particularly India, there will be a in Delhi, there is a National Service Legal Metrology lab is also available in order to introduce all the make the amendments in the metrology point of view. But if you look at the deterministic metrology point of view, you can say it is a process measurement in front of the product inspection. Particularly if we take it is applicable to nanotechnology or the some advanced things. Because in this deterministic metrology, the inspection is carried out during the product itself. Particularly if you look at the CNC machining point of view, with the help of this feedback system, inspection will be carried out, and any error deviation is there during the online itself. What happened? The product can be, error can be eliminated, at the end, we will get the finished product with the exact dimensions. But in the legal metrology point of view, what happened? The basic instruments is available. It is called as online inspection, offline inspection method. So, with the help of the measuring instrument, it can be inspected. So, in order to give the certain standards, what happened? The legal metrology has been defined. What are the methods can be used, what are the instruments can be used, what is the procedure, all can be defined in the legal metrology. Before going to talk about the legal metrology or the deterministic metrology, here, what is called as a measurement? Because in the metrology is always tells about the measurement of physical quantities. What is measurement? Measurement, if you point of view take the measurement means here, measurement, the important thing is first we must know there must be a measurement. Okay. Measurement. The measurement is nothing but any physical variable or any physical quantity is normally called it as a measurement. So measurement or the physical quantity will have the certain shape or certain dimensions and it will have certain property. Those property has to be measured with the help of the measuring instruments. Okay, so if you look at the physical variable means, it may be a pressure measuring, it may be a temperature measuring, or it may be density, whatever it may be. Even if you look at the medical application point of view, you are measuring the temperature of the body, you are measuring the heartbeat of the heart, right? Everything to be measured and also to be maintained in the controlled way. That's why the process engineering metrology is playing a vital role in industry. Here, I want to know what is my measurement means. The measurement, the physical variable of the given part to be measured with the help of instrument. For that, there will be a comparison we are doing. What kind of comparison means? So, in order to measure the unknown value of this physical variable,
you are going to use the certain known things, known standard, okay. Here, the known value is called as a standard value. Here, the process is nothing but comparison process. The physical variable's properties can be compared with the known variable. Okay, known variable, it is a standard value. This standard value is universally acceptable value and also it is a very accurate value. So, with help of this known value, this unknown value of physical parameter is normally compared. When comparing, we will have some results. That is called as an output, or you can say a result. The result will be displayed with the help of in the digital format or in the some other format. Okay. So the measurement process means the input parameter, input means there is a measurement or physical variable, then output will be the result. So how we got the result means by comparing the known standard with the unknown standard. This is the process behind the engineering metrology. So, in addition to that, I want to have some of the standard. What are the standards available or the known standard? I told you about the here known standard. Known standard means there are the four main standards there. The number one standard is called as international standard. International standard. The second one is called as primary standard. Third one is called as secondary standard. The fourth one is called as a working standard. Okay. International standard means it is always meant, it is accepted international agreement. Right. So, those agreement or the measurement can be always verified with the help of the standard physical science methods. Okay. So, it will not be available in every country. It is internationally, it is a common agreement frame and according to the international standard, universally it is followed. If you look at the primary standard, the primary standard, every country will have the own laboratory, that is called it is a NSLM laboratory. They will always retain the certain equipments for the calibration purpose. It cannot be used for some other purpose. Here the primary standard is only available, will be available in the National Service Vehicle Metrology Laboratory, particularly for India, it is available in New Delhi. And secondary standard means it is applicable into the industry, every industry, they will have in their laboratory, they will have their own setup, the tool room, lab will be there. In the tool room, they will have a certain kind of instrument for calibration. Okay, and apart from that, these primary standard instruments always will be calibrated frequently with the primary standards. So, the secondary standard is suitable to the consign industry in the tool room. Then it will be used for the inspection in the particular industry. In a working standard is nothing but it is used for the purpose of inspection in the shop floor. In the shop floor, the labor will undergo some kind of manufacturing process. They will do the inspection. Therefore, inspecting that component, they will use the instrument which is used for the inspection is called it is a working standard. This working standard also will be calibrated periodically with the secondary standard. So, standard is nothing but this is a known quantity and a universally acceptable one for the measuring purpose. This is feedback. So I am finishing this introduction to metrology. The feature, we will look about what are the methods of measurements, what are the errors in measurements and what is the advances is available in metrology. Because current scenario, the people started to use the instruments of non-contact instruments. Because in contact system, the physical variable is instrument is made to contact with the physical variable and we are missing. But currently scenario, the people started to use the non-contact system without touching the component of the component, they started to measure the physical variable. So, in the future classes, I would like to cover those courses. Thank you for your time. Thank you.